Joinum software. In this video, we will understand the tax configuration in Joinum software. So in the product, the tax calculation is done automatically based on the state, the service provider and service consumer. Based on the combinations, the configuration is automatically done. So in this product, the configuration of charges and tax done at three different levels. One, at company level. So the merchants, if you don't want to follow the product schemes or the branching concept, you can configure tax at one place, that is under ledger and add to favorite. Here you can define the tax. The second level of customers, if you want to follow the product scheme, but you do not have a branching concept. So you can do it, master setup, product scheme. And here you can create a scheme and click ledger. So here you can configure it. And third kind of configuration is done at branch level. Okay. So before we proceed, let me delete this product schemes which were created for testing purpose. So 100 days product scheme, 2% ROI monthly for 100 day. I click save. Now I did not do any configuration of fees and charges at product scheme level because I want to do it at branch level. So in master setup branch hierarchy, I have configured states, like I have configured few states in India, and here I have configured Karnataka, and in that Bangalore city. So if I see Karnataka state, what configuration I have done, so we can see here I have configured document charges and I configured is a tax applicable and 4%, then CGST 9%, SGST and IGST 9%, it should be 18%. So IGST should be 18%. So let me delete this and configure IGST 18%. And okay, so IGST is applicable all states other than Karnataka. So I can mention something like the state codes or identification number separated by comma. Karnataka state code is 29, so I will skip that and enter all other states here. I click add and I click close. Now let's take a look whether configuration is done or not for Karnataka state. It is done. Now let's configure for Maharashtra state. I click here and here we can see that document charges here configure 5%. 9%, 9%, 18%. Only thing we'll have to keep in mind that CGST is applicable for same state. So 27, then SGST 27 if the customer belongs to same state, and IGST if the customer belongs to any state other than Maharashtra. So this configuration is also done. Now what I want to do, I want to create two customers just to replicate this scenario correctly. So I create customer Maharashtra and select any city which belongs to Maharashtra, and location I enter state code. Then I create another customer, customer Karnataka, belongs to Bangalore, and location state code 29. That is the state code for Karnataka. I click save. Okay, now what I do, I search customer. So I will get two customers here. Maharashtra and Karnataka. Okay, now, but before that, we would like to first understand where exactly I am working, in which state actually I am working in. So if I click here, my branch is India currently. Okay, so let me change this branch and let me set the branch, my working branch, as Maharashtra. I click set branch and close. Now I search customer. And here I click loan for Maharashtra customer. I click loan. Now we can understand here document charges CGST and SGST automatically configured. Let's say my amount is 20,000. So 1,000, that is 5%. Of 20,000, 1,000 is document charges, CGST applied on 1,000 and accordingly. So whatever my amount, actually it will calculate automatically. Let's say amount is 24,500, so it will calculate accordingly. Let's keep 10,000 here and I click, let me select a product scheme here, because rest of the configuration is done accordingly. I calculate here. It will tell me that whatever amount deducted here and the remaining amount to pay. I click save. Loan 54 is calculated, created. Now the same thing we do for, so I am in Maharashtra set because I have set up a branch as Maharashtra, and now I want to give a loan to customer who belongs to Karnataka. I click loan. Now let's understand here. Now automatically IGST is configured. Let me select product scheme and enter amount 10,000. So we can see now 500, because 5% for Maharashtra, and this is 18% on 500. Calculate and click save. Now let's try to do this considering that I am working from Karnataka now. Set branch and close. And I search customer as now Maharashtra customer. So assuming my office is in Karnataka, but that's why I set up the branch as Karnataka, and customer, I want to give loan to customer belongs to Maharashtra. Now IGST. And here document charges, very interesting to know, because we configure 400 for 4% for Karnataka. So see, 400 has come here and then 72, and calculate and click save. Okay, so it's very simple. We don't have to do a lot of calculations, and using all these concepts and automation, the whole purpose is to speed the business as well as avoid the manual errors. And these accesses also can be remote if the loan is disbursed by the staff. Okay, and at the last test, that is customer belongs to Karnataka state and the branch is also Karnataka, so it should be 400 plus 99%. All right, so I hope you like this concept. And as I explained, if you want to define that product scheme, that also you can do it. But in that case, your product scheme and your state level configuration will conflict in case they are duplicate. So for example, product scheme, you can create something like, let's say processing fees, because document charges we have configured at branch level. So at product scheme level, you can configure something, let's say processing fees, okay, 2%, and apply tax, or maybe the best example is, let's say, insurance charges, on which I don't want any tax applicable, and insurance charges, let's say 5%, and no tax applicable. I click add, I click close. Now let's try to understand. If I search a customer which belongs to Karnataka, click loan. Now let's see what happens. So document charges, CHGST and CGST and SGST, but what about insurance charges? That is not shown here because we did not select a product scheme 8. I select product scheme and now insurance charges here. And let's give amount 10,000. Now interesting part, 500, 400, 900, and but note down that this 9% added on 400, not on 900. Okay. So that's how it is configured here. It looks very simple, but a lot of processing happens in the background to make it easy for you. So 972 for this, and then calculate to this much. And one more thing, let's say for all product schemes, whichever product scheme you create, you want to apply one specific charge on all product schemes, let's say 1% processing charge. So what we can do is ledger add to favorite. What we can do, I select processing fees already here, processing fees, and let's have 1% here. Okay. And tax applicable for processing fee, we can say yes or no, whatever you decide. But let's say if I say tax applicable, yes, save, close. Now what will happen, irrespective of any product scheme, processing fee will always be selected. Okay, so now I click loan here for this customer, and let's see what are things. So processing fees, because this is configured at company level, document charges configured at branch level, and configured at branch level. So these taxes, we mentioned that apply on these two charges because we said that tax applicable for these two charges. Now I select here 100 days and 10,000. Now let's see how it works. So 500 on 500, 99%, and then 500 here, no tax. So it's total coming here like this. I click calculate, and this much amount to pay. I click save, and let's search loan 59, how it looks. Now if we go, so here we can see that 10,000 principal, interest whatever we charge, and then this amount, installments, I think 100 installments created, and transaction. So the breakup of whatever charges applied. Okay. All right. So thank you so much for your time and watching this video. Please subscribe to Jainam Software channel so that new features you will be notified. And also please share this video. Thank you so much. Have a great day.